Whoa, once again, everybody, I'm Jeff, and welcome back to the Gridiron. Right now, it's time to preview the NFC home games for Week 11. I want to start off with my key game, which winds up being for these two teams. Very special game indeed. The Titans go to the Georgia Dome to play the Atlanta Falcons. Now, the Falcons just came off of a tough loss, shall we say. I don't want to say heartbreaking, because when you go for a 4th-and-1, you're on 29, you know, and you don't get it in overtime, it's all or nothing. It's all or nothing. They didn't get it. It was a tough loss. Titans prevailing last week, looking very good in Carolina. Carolina coming off a bye, figure they would at least maybe put up some points or maybe look somewhat kind of good. Coming off they looked horrible. Tennessee putting it to the Panthers last week, 30-3. Not only that, but it was Chris Johnson had a season high, 130 yards rushing. Very, very good. Now the Titans have been dominating the NFC opponents. They won 18 out of the last 20 games against some NFC opponents. They're looking to try to continue that streak. Now, the Titans have the worst running offense in the NFL, giving up, only 81 yards a game on the ground. Not going to get it done. Okay. The Falcons have the third best run defense. They only give up 90 yards a game. Part of that is because the Falcons' passing defense isn't quite as good. I believe they give up almost 250 yards a game passing, and they don't have a great pass rush. So the best way to attack the Atlanta Falcons defense would be through the air. So I mean, if you can just walk up and down the field, not that teams do that, but you're not going to run the ball as much. I do believe that the Titans are going to try to need to establish the run. All right, obviously maybe try to keep the Falcons in their offense off the field. Now we got Johnson. All right, the Titans are 3-0 when Johnson gets at least 15 carries. That's not a boatload of carries. Okay, 15 carries isn't a lot. And so I think that might be the benchmark for what the Titans might want to try to do this week. Try to get him at least 15 carries, possibly much more than that, but try to get him his carries. But if it's not doing well at first, stick with the game plan, keep beating the ball. It could prove well worth it in the end for you. All right. Now, likewise, the Falcons, speaking of running games, they won 5 out of the last 6, right? When Michael Bonner Turner gets at least 19 carries in a game, they won 5 out of 6. Their one loss was last week when they lost to the New Orleans Saints. Turner had 22 carries for 96 yards. The Falcons could have won that game, but you know, different story. Let's see. Matt Ryan last week threw for career high, 351 yards rushing on 351 yards passing on 52 pass attempts. That's also a career high for him. But however, Falcons are 3-11 when Matt Ryan throws 40 plus passes per game. So they want to, obviously, same thing I'm looking at with the Falcons, try to get the ball to Michael Turner's hands. Good things happen when Michael Turner gets the ball a good amount of times. Bad things happen to the Falcons when Matt Ryan has to throw the ball a good amount of times. Now the Falcons are 5-4. So are the Titans at 5-4. The Titans have won 5 straight games against the Atlanta Falcons, dating back to September 9th, 1990, when the Tennessee Titans were the Houston Oilers. They won 47-27 that day. Also, at the 15-game home winning streak for Matt Ryan, okay, he's dropped 4 out of his last 7 games at home, including last year's playoff loss to the Packers. The Titans coming up, kind of an up and down schedule. They have some tough games, Springer, then they got Atlanta, then they got Tampa Bay. coming to Tennessee. Then they got to go to play Buffalo. Could be a very tough one. Then they got New Orleans coming to town. Will we see New Orleans be a little, more human-like, especially, on the road, on grass and all that, where they're not, like, the greatest show on turf. So when they go in Tennessee, they won't be quite as potent as they can be on artificial turf. Then they got to play in Indianapolis. Then they got Jacksonville coming home. Then the final game of the season, they got to go on the road in Houston. Now, the Titans are a game and a half behind the idle Texans, who have the bye this week. Titans looking, if they can get this one, they'll be only one game back behind the Texans. Texans are going to be getting Johnson back. They're looking forward to that after the bye, but they lost Matt Schaub for the season, so that's a big blow to him. Matt Gilmore will have to wait and see if Matt Leinart can do it. However, the Texans do have that potent running game, so Matt Leinart can kind of hand the ball off quite a bit, and hopefully they can get by. For the Texans' sake, hopefully they can get by just handing the ball off. Not obviously knowing that Matt Schaub's not going to be in the backfield for him. Now the Falcons, all right, they have a little easier schedule. They got Tennessee at home, then they got Minnesota at home, then they got to go in Houston to play the Texans, then they got Carolina at home, another winnable game. They got to play in Carolina, that's a winnable game. Jacksonville coming in Atlanta, that's a winnable game. Then they got to play in New Orleans, second last game of the season. All right, that's going to be a tough one for them, very, very tough one. Then they got Tampa Bay coming home. So the Falcons got some winnable games. Now that's the second last game of the season, playing against the Saints in New Orleans. Could be a huge one if the Falcons can start getting. Well, they won three in a row before they lost last week, so they won three out of the last four. They're starting to step it up, okay? As I said, both these teams are huge, huge games, okay? Atlanta wants to keep winning, so hopefully they can, maybe catch New Orleans. With the Saints, they're only competing against a few other teams as far as play a wild card. So if they don't get the number one, they don't win the division. In the NFC East, there's the Giants. Right now, it's only got the Giants and the Cowboys. Okay, you got the Packers winning their division, but then you got the Bears and the Lions. So Bears and Lions, they only have three losses. The Cowboys, they're in second place, but they have four losses. The Falcons have four losses. Okay, then you have the Tampa Bay. It seems to be a disappointment this year. It doesn't look like they're going to possibly make the playoffs. And then you got in the West, my goodness gracious, you got the 49ers running away with that division. Nobody else in that division has even come close to a winning record, so nobody in that division is going to make the playoffs as a wild card. So the Falcons are competing against just a few other teams for those two wild card spots. So if they can at least win most of these games here, they have a very good shot at least making the playoffs. The Titans, on the other hand, if they're looking to catch the Texans, if they don't catch the Texans. I mean, you still got Buffalo. I believe what Buffalo has, four losses. The Jets have four losses. The Titans have four losses. But then you got the Bengals have three losses. The Steelers have three losses. The Ravens have three losses. All right, that's tough there. A lot of teams there with three losses that could possibly either win a division or maybe be a wild card team. Then you got the West. There's only one team coming out of that division. Who's it going to be? I have no idea. If I was going to bet right now, I'm going to say Tim Tebow and the Broncos, the way they keep winning. But, Atlanta has a good shot, all right, of at least making the playoffs if they can win the winnable games anyway. Titans have a tougher road ahead of them. I'm going to give this one to Atlanta. I think Atlanta will win it. I think at home, I think they're dropping just a little more explosive. I mean, last week, with Julio Jones, I know he's banged up, but if he plays, his presence is still there. Tony Gonzalez, Michael Barnett, Turner, Roddy White, all right, and then last week, Howie Douglas. He had a phenomenal game for him last week. What a game he had, huh? It should be a hard-fought game, close game. I said the Falcons wind up winning by, like a touchdown, maybe 24-17 or so. I think running the ball is going to be very, very important. Obviously, ball, no turnovers. Don't give either team a chance. Right? No stupid turnovers at all. But running the ball is very, very important. But I'm going to give the nod, a slight nod, to the Falcons. Now, the rest of the games, the NFC games, got quite a few of them for week 11. The Eagles at the Giants. Now, I'm going to take the Giants. I hate jinxing them. I hate picking them, especially against the Eagles. The Eagles always beat up on the Giants. Giants did prevail earlier this season. All right, but the Eagles always seem to have it, especially DeSean Jackson. Shady McCoy does very good against them. Now, Michael Vick got the two broken ribs. He's supposed to going to play, has been practicing, and he's going to be playing now. So, obviously, that's going to hamper him throwing. He's not going to want to take as many hits and all that. So, the Giants, after this, they got to play New Orleans. They got to play Green Bay. They got to play the Cowboys. The Giants really need to win this game. Very, very important game for the Giants. Going to take the Giants. I hope I'm not jinxing them. But then they got Tampa Bay at Green Bay. Rodgers still got the belt. I'm not taking it from him. Neither is Tampa Bay. Go with the Packers. And they got Oakland at Minnesota. Ooh, I'll tell you. 1 week, I mean, it's... 1 week you got Tim Tebow in the second half beating up on the Raiders. Next week you got the Raiders. They looked very, very good last week. Going in and just whooping up on the Chargers. Only beat them by 7, but they ran the ball well. A lot of pressures on Rivers. I'm gonna take the Raiders. Carson Palmer getting a little more knowledge and experience with his receivers. He's the better quarterback. Bush running the ball, so I'll give it to the Raiders. The Raiders need it. Vikings aren't going to the playoffs. The Raiders do need this one. Obviously, the Vikings want to win it as well, but I mean, I'll give it to the Raiders. Carolina at Detroit, take the Lions. They need to win this one. They've been stumbling lately. They're at home against a winnable opponent. They need to win this one. Give it to the Lions. Cowboys at Washington. I think the Cowboys got a little too much firepower for the Redskins. I'm going to give it to the Cowboys. They always play tough games. Usually Washington seems to want to win at least one of the games during the season between the two teams, but I'm going to give this one to the Cowboys. Arizona at San Fran. I don't think I need to say too much on that one. Take San Fran. Hopefully they don't have a hangover from the Giants game from last week, because the Cardinals can come in and as we saw, they can win. If not win, they almost beat the Ravens in Baltimore. So they've got to be careful. But I'll give it to the 49ers. Got Atlanta over Tennessee. Then you got Chicago and San Diego. Chicago's looking good. San Diego's kind of not looking so good. They're going down. Their stock's going down. Chicago's kind of on the rise. Chicago's looking very good. So it's in Soldier Field. I'll give it to the Bears. And then we got Seattle at St. Louis. Since it's in St. Louis, look for Steven Jackson. Maybe have another phenomenal game. Look for the Rams. Maybe win their third game in a row. They aren't a team that I picked to win that division. Too little, too late. But look for the Rams to win in St. Louis at home over the Seahawks. All right. So week 11 in the NFC, we got Giants over the Eagles, Packers over the Bucks, Raiders over the Vikings, Lions over the Carolina Panthers, Cowboys over the Redskins, 49ers over the Cardinals, Falcons in my key game over the Tennessee Titans, St. Louis Rams over the Seattle Seahawks, and finally Chicago Bears over the San Diego Chargers. Well, that's all time I have for right now. Next time I come back and see you, it's going to be time to start reviewing all the action that happened in Week 11 in the NFL. But until then, I'm Jeff. Thanks for watching, and remember, I'm going to see you on the ground.